Welcome to this video lecture. In this video lecture, let us learn about how to convert a given transfer function into a state space model. You know that the transfer function method of solving control system problems is an old method or a conventional method. This state space method is the new or the modern tool used to design and analyze your control system. So, if a transfer function is given, there should be some method to convert it to state space model. Similarly, if a state space model is given, then again there should be a method to convert it back to transfer function. That connection should be there between transfer function and state space model. So in that, let us see the first connection. If they give you the transfer function, then how to convert that into state space model. So let us see some of the numericals here. And one thing we should remember, the transfer function of any given problem or a system is unique always. Unique means for the same problem you cannot have two different transfer functions. Okay, but remember, state space model for any given control system is not unique. That means you have so many different forms of state model for the same given problem. So if the problem is for a given electrical system, find the state model, then the state model need not be same. It can be unique. Okay, so that is why transfer function is always unique. This transfer function of any given system is always unique, but the state space model for any given system is not unique. Okay, you can get different answers, but there are only particular number of methods you need to follow to get those answers. Only if you get those particular answers only, then you can tell that your problem solution is correct. Okay, so remember, transfer function is always unique, but state space model answer is not unique. It can be different. So that is why I have written three methods of converting transfer function to state space model. The first method is controllable canonical form. So your state space model can be of three forms. First one, your state space model can be controllable canonical form. It is just a name. You will understand why it is called controllable later in the unit. You will understand why it is called controllable canonical form, observable canonical form. Second one is observable canonical form. So there is one more form where you can represent the given state space model. That is called observable canonical form. OCF is the short form. And your state space model can also be represented as a third format called diagonal canonical form, and DCF is its short form. So as I told, the answer of the state space model is not unique. It changes. You can get different answers. How many different answers you can get? Only three different answers. So state space model can be of controllable canonical form answer, and observable canonical form answer, or diagonal canonical form answer. These are the three different forms you have for state space model. Okay, so now instead of studying the general meaning of controllable, observable, diagonal, we will straight away take one particular problem, where in that problem transfer function of the control system will be given, and that transfer function you need to convert it to state space model. Okay, all the three let us see in the same problem. By taking one single problem, we will see how to convert the transfer function into first one, controllable canonical form, second one, third one. Okay, all the three are state space models only, but the methods are different for each and every form of state space model. So we will see that problem now. Now consider this given transfer function. In this transfer function, how do you tell that this is a given transfer function? Y represents output, U represents input in your state space theory. Y means everywhere it is output, U means input. So it is a Laplace transform of output divided by input. So therefore the given equation is a transfer function of the control system. For this transfer function, you need to convert it into state space model. So all the three you need to do. convert this alpha function into CCF state space model, controllable canonical form, and convert this to observable canonical form state space model, DCF canonical form state space model. So all these forms are state space model only. State space model means what? How your answer should be represented at the end. Your answer should be like x dot is equal to ax plus b into u, and y is equal to cx plus d into u. So like this you should get the state space model. From the given transfer function you should convert that to this type of form. As in this type of form only you have three forms. Let us take the first form and we will see how to convert. So consider that you want to convert it into canonical form. Okay, controllable canonical form. So now what is the first step you need to do? See, whatever y of s by u of s is there, whatever y of s divided by u of s is there, that you have to write down as y of s divided by x1 of s into x1 of s divided by u of s. Can you divide and multiply x1 of s like this? Y by u can be written as y divided by x1 into x1 by u. X1, x1 cancel means you will again get the same thing, y by u only. So this x1 is the intermediate variable and that is what called as state variable. Okay. So now this is equal to the same thing. This is equal to, I'll get same thing, s cube plus 12s square plus 44s plus 48 divided by s cube plus 9s square plus 23s plus 15. Now always in any problem given you should equate this term to numerator. You should equate this term to numerator and you should equate x1 divided by u to denominator term. Always in any of the problem y divided by x1 you should equate to numerator. So what is the numerator here? S cube plus 12s square plus 44s plus 48. So therefore, y of s divided by x1 of s is equal to s cube plus 12s square plus 44s plus 48. And similarly, what is x1 of s divided by u of s? It is equal to denominator. Denominator means 1 divided by s cube plus 9s square plus, okay, 23s plus 15. Okay, so please remember that if you multiply this term with this term, you should get back your same original transfer function. Like that, you have to split. Always you take y by x1 as the numerator, x1 by u as the denominator for all problems. So now you multiply, cross multiply. Simply instead of writing y of s, I am simply writing it as capital Y. Okay, of s, I am not writing it down. So y is equal to s cube into x1. Again, instead of x1 of s, I am simply writing it as x1 plus 12s square into x1 plus 44s into x1 plus 48x1. Cross multiply it. Now apply inverse Laplace transform. It is in S domain. S domain means it is in Laplace transform. Convert it into inverse Laplace transform. Small y is equal to x1 triple dot. Okay, why I am writing triple dot for x1? You know that s cube into x1, okay, according to Laplace transform property, if you have s cube into x1, its Laplace transform, inverse Laplace transform is, because s cube is there, in after inverse Laplace transform, you should write down 3 times differentiation of x1. Here capital x1, here small x1, because it is inverse Laplace transform. So after inverse Laplace transform, s cube into x1 becomes x1 3 dots. 3 dots indicates 3 times differentiation. S cube means differentiation in time domain. Okay. Now what happens to 12s square x1? 12 will be as it is. Now s square into x1 after inverse Laplace transform, it becomes equal to x1 double dot. Double dot means 2 differentiation plus 44 s into x1 is there, s into x1. So after inverse Laplace transform we'll get x1 single dot, because only s is there, no, plus 48 into capital X1. S is not present here, so differentiation will not come here. So it is a capital X1. After inverse Laplace transform, it becomes small x1. Understood? Now it is time for us to define the state variables. How many state variables will be there for any given problem? See, remember, what is the order of the given problem? What is the order of the given problem? Numerator order is 3, denominator order is 3. Then which one you have to consider? Whichever is bigger, that you have to take as the order of the system. So here both are equal, no? So I am going to take the order is equal to 3. Whichever is bigger, you have to take that as the order of the system. Here both numerator denominator highest power of s are same. That's why I am taking order is equal to 3. Remember, whatever order you get, those many number of state variables you will have in the problem, not more than that. So if order is equal to 3, then the state variables will also be equal to 3 only. You, instead of 3, if you take 4, then that will be wrong. So identify how many, what is the order of the given system. From that you have to find out the state variable. So totally there are 3 state variables. What are the state variables? X1, X2, X3. That is what the name I am going to use it, right? So X1, here only let me write. The 3 state variables are X1, X2 and X3. These are the 3 state variables you have to take. Have you already taken X1? Yes. So X1 is defined already. So what is left out now? X1 is already taken and we don't know what is X2 and we don't know what is X3. So it is time for us to define these two, X2 and X3. So now how to define X2 and X3? See, this X1 is done already. X1 you have defined, this X1 you have defined already. Now coming to this X1 dot. So let me take this X1 dot. So leaving this X1 because it does not contain any dot. So it is a first state variable. Now I need to define my second state variable, X2. So whatever you have after X1, you leave that. After this, whatever you have, after means before this, if you leave this X1 without a dot term, if you leave that, now whatever you have X1 dot. So this X1 dot, can I call it as the second state variable? Okay, so I am going to equate this X1 dot as second state variable. For all problems, you have to do like this only. After getting the equation for Y, identify which term is not having dot. That term without a dot, the term which do not contain any dot. After getting the equation for Y, any term which do not contains dot, that you leave it off. After leaving that, you should go back in the reverse direction. Okay, when you go back in the reverse direction, first you will get as a single dot. After you will get double dot. After you will get triple dot. Like this only you have to go, like ascending order. So leaving this without dot term, the next term is x1 dot. So this I can take it as second state variable x2. So call this x1 dot as second state variable x2. Now after this second state variable, let us go for the next one. X1 double dot is there, no? So can I call this x1 double dot as my third state variable x3? Yes. Now call this x1 double dot as third state variable x3. Now can I call this x1 triple dot as my fourth state variable x4? No, because you came to know the order of the system is only 3. That means your state variables will only be 3 only, not more than 3 you should take. So you should stop only x1 dot and x1 double dot. You should not take x1 triple dot. Why? Because x1 is taken, x2 is taken, x3 is taken, x4 you should not take. So this you have to keep it as it is. This x1 triple dot, you should not write it as x3. I mean, you should not write this x1 triple dot as x4. That is not allowed because there are only 3 state variables present. So then what can I write this x1 double dot as? Can I write this x1 double dot as x3 single dot? You know that x3 is what? X1 double dot. If you put one more dot, here also you should put one more dot, no? So x1 triple dot is nothing but previous x3 double dot. Okay, so you should not write this value as x4 because 4 state variables is not allowed in this problem. because order of the system is 3. That's why the last one, what I'm doing is, I'm just taking whatever you have for previous x3, that x3 double, single dot I'm taking. Okay? Now, rewrite the equation. If you rewrite the equation for y, so y is equal to x3 dot plus 12x3 plus 44x2 plus 48x1. Now you take x3 you take on one side, remaining everything you send it to other side. Okay, so now what happens if you rearrange it? You will get minus 12x3 minus 44x2 minus 48x1 plus y. So all these terms I am sending it to one side. So all the plus terms becomes minus. Y anyhow is plus only. So y I am writing it as plus. Now is this a state equation? Yes. Because the state equation should be x dot is equal to ax plus bu. It should be like that. Correct, no? So here, is it looking like the same thing? X dot is equal to x3, x2, x1. All x terms are there, but instead of x dot should depend on x and u. So it is depending on x, but it is not depending on u. Y is the unknown term. So what you do? You keep a mark for y, indicating that is an unknown term. Okay. So what is this y? This is an unknown term. We will see what we need to do for that y term later. Now coming to this second part, we will see what has to be done. Cross multiply the second path, you will get x1 into s cube plus 9s square plus 23s plus 15 is equal to u. Can I interchange left hand side, right hand side? U is equal to x1 into s cube plus 9s square into x1 plus 23s into x1 plus 15x1. Now take inverse Laplace transform on both sides. So you'll get small u is equal to x1 double triple dot, because s cube is there, plus 9x1 double dot plus 23x1 double dot. Sorry, single dot. Okay, because 23 single s is there, so single dot you will get after inverse Laplace transform. Plus here there is no s present, so after inverse Laplace transform it will only become small x1, 15x1. Now what is the substitution we made in the previous here? We took x1 dot as x2. And we took x1 double dot as x3, and x1 triple dot, we took x1 triple dot as x3 dot. So now what happens? You rewrite the equation. U is equal to x3 triple dot plus 9x3 plus 23x2 plus 15x1. Now here, can you write x3 on one side? So if you write x3 dot as one side, now what is the expression you will get? x3 on one side, then all these term will go to the other side. Minus 15x1 minus 23x2 minus 9x3 plus u. Okay. Now is it in the form what we require? What is that we require? State model, no? X dot should be depending on x and u. Is it depending? Yes, x dot is depending on x and u. Yes, it is exactly matching our state equation here like this. So therefore, it's exactly matching. So therefore, this equation is very important for us, because it is matching our state space model. So this is very important for us. Okay. Now, can you substitute this x3 value in this y equation, can you substitute? Is this important for us? X3 dot f, this equation is not important for us. Why? Because x dot should depend on x values and u, but here x3 is depending upon x values and y, so it is not important for us. So this is not required for us, but instead of that I require this equation. So you can cancel this off. So I don't want this, you better cancel this off, because this is it is not giving any help for us, correct? So that's why let me cancel it. And now, what is that we can write? If you substitute this x3 dot here, what we can write? Y is equal to minus 15x1 minus 23x2 minus 9x3 plus u plus 12x3 plus 44x2 plus 48x1. Now, which are the common terms? You can add the common terms. X1, add it with X1. X2, add it with X2. X3, add it with X3. So, if you add the common terms and simplify, what is the expression you are going to get for Y? Y expression, you are going to get the expression for Y after adding the common terms as 33X1 plus 21X2 plus 3x3 plus u term is there, no? See here u, this is u, please don't understand this as 4, this is u, so this u will come here. Okay, now is this important for us? Yes. See, y should depend on x and u. Yes, y is depending on x values and u. So, this is important for defining my state model. So, put a box for this. That means this equation is important. Now, what are the other equations you have? What is that assumption you made? You made x2 is equal to what? What is that? X1 dot is equal to x2 here. X1 dot is equal to x2. So, this is also important for us. Because x should depend on x and then u. U is not there, that's all. So this equation also you have to put in a box. And there is one more equation. What is it? X2 dot. What is x2 dot is equal to? See, x2 dot, here I will write down. Actually, what is x2? X2 is equal to x1 dot. So if you put x2 dot, then what will be x1 double dot, correct? No, already one dot is there for x1. If you put one more dot for x2, then you will get x1 double dot. So instead of x1 double dot, instead of x3, I can also write it as x2, correct? So remember, this term is nothing but x2, x2 dot, I'm sorry. That term is nothing but x2 dot. So can I tell x2 dot is equal to x3? Yes. So I am going to write down here. So x2 dot is equal to x3. So is this important equation for us? Yes. X should depend on x and u. U is not there. So this equation is also important. So how many state equations you got? X1 dot, x2 dot, x3 dot. So, all these together will be equal to capital X dot. Okay. Now, what is this Y? This equation. So, this equation of Y will give you capital Y is equal to Cx plus du. So, only thing you need to finally represent it in a form of a state model. So, whichever equations you require, those equations you have to put a box like this. So, now let me write it in a proper state space model. Your problem calculation is over. Only you need to write it in a proper state space model. Now these are the equations what we got. These are the equations what we got from the previous analysis. Okay, I have simply rewritten it once again. Now how to represent this in the form of a matrix form? Write x1 dot, x2 dot and x3 dot all as a column vector, and then you call this as x1, x2 and x3 state variables, and then you call it as a matrix multiplied by u. Okay, it is like what? It is like x dot is equal to ax plus b into u, like that. Okay, now what is a matrix you have to fill? A is what for x1 dot x2 only. So x2 only should be there. X2 is the second element, so only second element should be 1. X1 and x2, first and third element should not be there. So 0, 1, 0. Okay, now coming to this x2 dot is second equation, which is equal to x3. X3 is the third element, so only third element should be 1. X2 should be 0, x1 should be 0. It is not there in the x2 dot equation. That's why 0, 0, 1. Now what happens to this x3 dot third equation? X1 is also there, x2 is also there, x3 is also there, right? Minus 15 for x1. So minus 15 will come here. 23 for x2, that will come here, minus 23. 9, minus 9 for x3, that will come here, minus 9. Okay, and u, is there u present for x1 dot x2 dot? No. So for first x1 dot, there is no u present. Okay, and for second x2 dot also, there is no u present. So here also, it is 0. And for the third x3 dot, there is one u term. What is multiplied for u? Nothing. Nothing means 1. So I have to write for the third equation, I have to write 1. Okay. So now this is your complete state space model. Okay. Whatever the transfer function they had given, that I have converted capital A. Capital A is given by this big matrix. And capital X is x1, x2, x3. B is nothing but 0, 0, 1, B matrix. U means U only. Okay, it is a single input, that's why small u I am writing. Now, I should write one more matrix form for this Y term. So, how to write one more matrix for this Y term? So, Y is equal to 33, 21, 3. Okay, that should be multiplied by x1, x2 and x3. 33, 21, 3. Okay. And plus u is there. Because one u term is there, what you should do? You have to multiply 1 into u. Okay. So now it is like which form? This is like which form? Capital Y is equal to C into X plus D into u. Now what is C? C is nothing but 33, 21, 3. That is your row vector. X is this and D is a 1 cross 1 matrix. Remember, for single input, single output, capital D, you are always going to get 1 cross 1 only. Okay, sometimes D will be 0. So, complete you won't get this term at all. Right now in this problem you got U is this. So, this is your controllable canonical form of the given transfer function. Now let us do for the same problem, let us do OCF, observable canonical form. Okay, I'll consider the same transfer function given, y of s divided by u of s, given s cube plus 12 s square plus 44 s plus 48 divided by s cube plus 9s square plus 23s plus 15. This was the same equation. Again the order is equal to 3. And again, how many state variables you need to take? Only 3. That is x1, x2 and x3. So now what is the first step you need to do? Without, like in the previous, don't take that step. You directly cross multiply without taking any intermediate step. So y into s cube plus 9s square plus 23s plus 15 is equal to u into s cube plus 12s square plus 44s plus 48. Now you multiply it inside. S cube y plus 9s square y plus 23s into y plus 15y is equal to s cube u plus 12 s square u, okay, plus 44 s u plus 48 u. Now you take inverse Laplace transform on both the sides. So we'll get y double triple dot plus 9 y double dot plus 23 y single dot plus 15 y is equal to u triple dot plus 12 u double dot plus 44 u single dot plus 48 u. Like this I got. Now keep this y triple dot on the LHS. Remaining everything you take to the RHS. These are the steps you need to repeat for observable canonical form. So y triple dot you keep it here. Remaining you take u triple dot plus 12 u double dot plus 4 u double dot plus 48 u minus 9 y double dot minus 23 y dot plus 15 y. Now you differentiate 3 times. How to guess the differentiate? Because there are y triple dot present on the LHS. To remove all these triple dot on the LHS, then you have to integrate it thrice. Okay, I'm sorry, I wrote it as differentiation. Actually, it is integration. So because you need to remove the dots, dot means differentiation, then you have to take integration. So integrate thrice on both sides. Why thrice you understood? Because you need to remove 3 dots on the RHS. Now what happens? Complete y. Triple dot is gone. So here u triple dot will become u plus 12 single integration u plus 44 double integration u plus 48 triple integration u minus 9 single integration y minus 23 double integration y plus 15. Why did I write plus 15? I'm sorry. So when this plus 15 comes on the other side, it should be minus 15. I'm sorry for that. So this should be minus. This also should be minus. Minus 15. Triple integration y. Now group all the single and double terms. So this is the only one term without integration sign. Keep it as it is. Now wherever triple integrations are there, I am going to group. Or wherever single integration, let us go in the ascending order. Single integration, two integration, three integration. Like that I will take. So single integration, wherever you have, take common. 12u and minus 9y. Correct, no? Minus 9y plus. Now take double integration common. What is left out? 44u minus 23y. 44u minus 23y. Now take the triple integrations common. What is left out if you take triple integration? 48u minus 15y. 48u minus 15y. So these are the things. So I have just grouped into single integration, double integration and triple integration as common. Now whatever you have, wherever you have integration sign from here, no, this entire equation. So this entire equation, you take it as a first state variable x1. Wherever integration sign is there, that entire thing you will take it as first state variable. This entire thing, let me call it as first state variable x1. So now what happens to your y? Let us see in the next slide. Now what happens? What is y? Y is equal to u plus x1. Okay. Now call this as equation 1. Your equation should be of which form? X dot is equal to ax plus b into u. And y is equal to cx plus d into u. Like this it should have. Now is it matching? Y should depend on u and x. Y should depend on u and x. Right. So this is important for us. Mark it with a box and call it as equation 1. Now what is x1? We took the previous entire, wherever integrations are there, that entire thing we took it as x1. All problems you should do same thing. Wherever integrations are there, that entire you group it and take it as first state variable x1. Now what is x1 is equal to? This x1 is equal to single integration 12u minus 9y plus double integration 44u minus 23y plus triple integration 48u minus 15y. Now you take differentiation on both sides. Why I'm taking? Because I want x dot, no? That's why I'm differentiating on both sides one time. So it becomes x1 dot is equal to, integration is gone, 12u minus 9y plus one integration is gone, 44u minus 23y, one integration is gone, 48u minus 15y. Now again you got some terms without integration and some terms with integration, no? Now again you call this term whichever containing integrations, this you call it as second state variable x2. Now rewrite the equation. X1 dot is equal to 12u. What is y? Y I know it from the equation 1. Substitute u plus x1 plus x2. I am calling that as x2. Now x1 dot is equal to 12u minus 9u. X1 dot you will get it as 12u minus 9u becomes 3u. Minus 9x1 plus x2 plus 3u. So you call this as equation number 2. This is important, you put it inside box. Why? Because my x dot depends on x and u. So this is important to write my state model. Okay. Now continue with the next x2. What is x2 taken? Like this. So now you take this x2 and continue like that. Okay. So this repeats until you get the complete state model. So now I am going to take, can I write directly x2 dot? I am writing that x2 dot like here, from here. So x2 dot, if you take this single integration will go. So you are left with 44u minus 23y plus single integration 48u minus 15y. Now again you got some terms with integration and without integration. So wherever integration is there, that you group it as the next variable. So this you group it as the next state variable x3. Only three state variables are possible. Now rewrite the equation. Rewrite the equation. X2 dot is equal to 44u minus 23. Y, you know it from equation 1. U plus x1. U plus x1 plus x3. Now what happens for x2 dot? What is the equation you will get for x2 dot? You will get it as minus 23x1, if you simplify, plus x3 plus 21u. Okay, this is also important for us. Mark it as equation number 3. Why it is important? Because x dot is depending on x and u. That's why it is important. Now, what is the x3 you have assumed? That you take it and continue further. So, I'll take this x3. Directly, can I write it as x3 dot? The answer. Okay, x3 dot is equal to. So, this single integration is gone. If you differentiate on x3. So, what is left out? 48u minus 15y. Now, again, you know what is y. From equation 1, substitute. So x3 dot is equal to 48u minus 15. What is y? U plus x1 from equation 1. Now if you simplify, you will get x3 dot is equal to minus 15x1 minus 15x1 plus 33u. So this is my, this is also important. Why? Because your x3 dot depends on x and u. So this is important. Now will you get x4? No, because only 3 state variables are there. So you have to stop the process here. And anyhow, you did not get any integration term here. So you have to stop. So now with equation 1, 2, 3, you have to write the state model. How to write the state model now? So I have to write now x1 dot, x2 dot and x3 dot is equal to, inside the matrix, here you have to write x1, x2, x3 plus some matrix into u. Now you need to fill this matrix. Now go to your x1, x1 dot is here. It depends on x1 and x2. So minus 9 and 1 for x2. x3 is not there. Minus 9, 1, x3 is not there. Now is there any u term present? Yes, 3 into u is there for the first equation. So for the first equation, 3 into u. So here you have to write 3. Now for the second equation, 23, x2 is not there. Minus 23 is there. So minus 23, 0, 1. And u will be 21 into u. Now the third equation, x1 is there, x2, x3 is not there. Minus 15x1. Minus 15x1, x2, x3 is not there. 0, 0. Now 33u. So you put here 33u. So this is your state space model. How is it represent? How it is looking like? It is like x dot is equal to a into x into b into u. So a is this matrix. A is called state matrix, capital A. B is 321. Now I have to write one more equation. No, why one more equation? Because of y is equal to cx plus du. So for that you can use equation 1. Y should depend on x and u. Right, it is right. So I can take equation 1 and write down my second state equation. So y is equal to some matrix multiplied by x1, x2 and x3. So which is that matrix? And also some matrix, 1 cross 1 matrix. Always you will get 1 cross 1 matrix for D, for CISO system. That you have to multiply with y. Sorry, u. That you have to multiply with u. D into u, no? That's it. So now, what is your equation 1? Equation 1 contains x1 only. So only x1 should be 1, first element. 1, x2 is not there, x3 is not there. And is it containing u? Yes, u term is there with 1. So I have to multiply u with 1. Yeah. Now it is looking like y is equal to cx plus du. So c is 1, 0, 0 matrix. D is 1 cross 1 matrix. It's a single number. Capital D is a single number for a CISO model. Single input, single output. U is 1 input, y is 1 output. So capital D will be always one, a single number for CISO system. And don't worry, you will get only problems on CISO. No, you will not get any problems on MIMO. So this completes, these two equations are called as your observable canonical form of the state space model. The given transfer function is converted into state space model. Is this answer similar to that of your previous controllable canonical form? No. The matrix is completely different. A is different, B is different, C and D both are different. All are different. So this is one more form. For the same transfer function, you got two different state models. That's why I told state model is not unique. Now we will see the last one, that is diagonal form, which is very easy. Now the third form of a state model is diagonal form. If any transfer function y of s by u of s is given, then that transfer function, you should first convert it into a transfer function which looks like this. This is like in partial fractions, okay? Whatever the transfer function they give like polynomial, that you have to use partial fractions and convert it like this. If you convert it like this, then your problem is 90% over. So b naught is a constant, c1 by first s plus p1, p2, p3 are poles of the denominator. okay, poles of your transfer function. Denominator roots are called p1, p2, p3. C1, c2, c3 are the partial fraction constants. You will understand when I solve the problem. Now, if you represent this transfer function like this, then how to write the state model? You don't have any lengthy procedure. Directly use this simple formula. Keep in mind this formula. X dot is equal to whatever the denominators you got, p1, p2, p3, that you have to write down here. Okay, so whatever the denominators you got, those p1 values you have to write it in an opposite way. Okay, that means opposite way means instead of p1 you have to write -p1, -p2, -pn, opposite. So if you get p1 is equal to 1, then you have to write -1 here, opposite, negative values. If you get p1 is equal to -1, then you have to write +1 here, output, negative values. So this is the correct formula. Into x1, x2, x3 plus term. This is a into x plus b. No, this b term for the diagonal form is always 1, 1, 1, 1 only. All ones you have to write into u. Why it is called diagonal form? Because in the diagonal, only for the diagonal you have the numbers. Other than the diagonals, it is 0. Any such matrix is called a diagonal matrix. It contains only non-zero values in the principal diagonal. All other elements of the matrix are zeros. That's why it is called diagonal form, diagonal matrix. Now y is equal to cx plus b, you know. What you should put in the place of c? Whatever the numerators you get, no, after partial fractions, those numbers you have to write down. c1, c2, c3, etc. into x plus. Now what you should write in the place of d? Y is equal to cx plus du is the formula. D, what is it that you should write for d? D should be equal to the constant. In the partial fractions, sometimes you will get the constant, sometimes you will not get the constant. If you don't get the constant, then that means b0 is equal to 0. That 0 you have to put here. Then this term goes out. It vanishes. In some partial fractions, you will get b0 value. That you have to substitute. Okay. Now using this formula, let us solve the problem. Now this is the same problem I am taking. Okay. So in this problem, first I have to do the partial fraction. To get the diagonal form of state space model, first step is to do the partial fraction. Can I do partial fraction directly here? The numerator power is equal to the denominator power. That means the partial fraction cannot be done at the first step. First you need to divide it once and then you have to apply the partial fraction. Now let me divide it. So s cube numerator plus 12s square plus 44s plus 48. This is 4. This you have to divide by what denominator? S cube plus 9s square plus 23s plus 15. Now you divide. What I have to take? S cube is there. I have to take the quotient in such a way that I have to vanish the first term. So the first term s cube and s cube, then the quotient I have to take 1 only, no? So the quotient is 1, then you will get s cube plus 9 square plus 23s plus 15. Now you subtract the thing, subtract. The first one definitely goes to 0 because you took the quotient in such a way. 12 minus 9 is 3 square. 44 minus 23 is 21 plus 21s, next plus 48 minus 15 is 33. Okay, that's all. Now you have to stop the division. Why? Because you have to divide until your numerator power becomes 1 lesser than the denominator. So now the power is what? 2. Now the denominator power is 3. So it is, the numerator power is 1 lesser than denominator. So that's why it is enough. You have to stop the division. Now I will rewrite the equation here. So y of s by u of s after division. The formula is like this. The formula is quotient plus remainder divided by denominator. This is the formula. Quotient plus remainder divided by denominator. See, this is your remainder. This is your quotient. And you know which is the denominator. So let me substitute. 1 plus remainder is what? 3 square plus 21 s plus 33 divided by denominator s cube plus 9 s square plus 23 s plus 15. This is y divided by u. I mean y of s divided by u of s. So first you have to do the partial fraction. But here the partial fraction was not able to complete because the numerator denominator highest powers were same. So first I divided it once. After getting numerator number lesser than denominator number, now I am going to do partial fractions. Now I have to do the partial fraction of this number. So take it separately. I am taking this separately, calling this equation 1. So 3s square plus 21s plus 33 divided by denominator you need to factorize. If you do the factorization of denominator, what is it you get in your calculator? First root is minus 1. Because you get minus 1, while writing the factor you have to put s plus 1. Second root you are going to get is minus 5. So then I have to write s plus 5. Third root you got is minus 3. Then I have to write s plus 3. Three roots I got for the denominator. Then I can write a divided by s plus 1. Partial fractions, you know that. B by s plus 5. And c divided by s plus 3. Now let me find the answer for a. So a is a 3s square. You know whichever method you are familiar for solving the a, b, c values of partial fractions, that only you can use. I am using easy method. A is having s plus 1. So let me take s plus 5, s plus 3 and substitute s is equal to minus 1. What is the answer we will get? So this is what I get after doing all calculations. You know anyhow how to do the partial fractions. So A is equal to 1.875 I got. B is equal to 0.375 I got. And capital C is equal to partial fraction constant 0.75 I got. Okay, so this ABC are the partial fraction constants. Don't confuse these ABC values with the state models. These are not the partial fraction constants. I mean these are the partial fraction constants. These ABC values you should not get confused with your state model. Okay, these are all ABC are the partial fraction constants. Let me write down. So these ABC are partial fractions, constants. These ABC are not your state model. These are the partial fraction constants. Now after getting this ABC value, substitute A 1.875, B and C. And this equation, whatever you got, that you resubstitute back in equation 1. 1 plus something divided by s plus 1 plus something by s plus 5 plus something by s plus 3 you will get. So your equation 1, how does it look like? Like this. Your equation 1 will look like 1 plus 1.875 by s plus 1 plus 0.375 by s plus 5 plus 0.75 by s plus 3. Now is it looking like your format which is required for diagonal canonical form? Yes, for diagonal canonical form it should be looking like this only. I'll show you. See, for diagonal canonical form, the formula, the transfer function should look like this. Some constant plus C1 by something, like partial fractions. That's why we did partial fractions first. After that, by looking into what is there in the numerator, denominator, construct this table. The diagonal should be P1, P2, P3, opposite of P1, P2, P3, negative sign. 1, 1, 1 into U. C1, C2, C3 are the constant numbers. Plus b0. If b0 is there, then you should write for y plus b0 into u. So let me substitute now. So what is the formula? How many equations you will get? 3 only, because the order of the system is 3. So you will get only 3 state variables. X1 dot, x2 dot and x3 dot on the left hand side. And that x1 dot, x2 dot, x3 dot is equal to what should be there here? Here you should write the diagonal elements. So this is P1, P2, P3. This is B0, C1, C2 and C3. Now substitute. So P1 is 1. So you put minus 1. P2 P2 is 5, so you put minus 5. Diagonally you should write. P3 is 3, so you put minus 3. And all other terms should be zeros. Fill all other values with 0. So it should be a 3 cross 3 matrix. That is multiplied by x. X means x1, x2, x3. And you know that all number of 1s should be, all the values should be 1. Okay. How many 1s you should put? 3. Because there are 3 state variables. That is multiplied by u. Always this value is 1 only. According to the diagonal form of the state space model. Now write the equation for y. Y is equal to c1, c2, c3. How many c1 are there? C1, c2, c3. 1.87, 0.375, 0.75. Substitute here. 1.875, 0.375, 0.75. This is multiplied with x. x1, x2, x3. Plus b0 into u. What is b0? 1. So 1 into u. 1 into u. So now this is your state space model. Diagonal canonical form of state space model DCF. Why it is called diagonal? Because the matrix A, this is capital A, no? Matrix. Capital A matrix is called state matrix. If your state matrix is written like a diagonal elements only, all other elements are zero, then you call this particular state model as a diagonal canonical form. So with this you understood that there are three different forms of representing a state model. One transfer function will give you three different state models. All the state models are correct only. Okay, so one transfer function can give you three state models. First one, controllable canonical form, observable canonical form, and diagonal canonical form. No theory, directly you have to remember the problem solving method for each and every formats of state space model. And the answer for each and every thing is different. But the question, transfer function is same. Okay, that's why state space model is unique. There are three formats for state space model. These are the three formats. So like this you can solve many other problems. Any problems they give you can solve for all controllable canonical form, observable, and then diagonal canonical form.